Hello, how are we doing? It's Thursday. Just a bit of a mix mash of a video. It's just, it's basically regarding my water carrier. It's just awful. I'm just trying to get to the bottom of it. Keep blaming the Easy Pod, like it's the Easy Pod's fault. Problem I'm having is it's almost like the Easy Pod can't hold enough fines for, you know, just like a vortex around the side of the Easy Pod. So you can, the water's going so dirty around the vortex side, so you know it's almost like the Easy Pod can't handle it. So I can't figure it out because I'm barely feeding. So then you've got obviously the showers full of sponges as well and filter floss and all sorts. So I definitely need more filtration. I wasn't expecting it to be this bad. So I'm cleaning these well every 2 days at the moment. So that's what the video's about. Also, I watched Koi Fish Johnny's UV bulb change. Sorry, mate, you made me laugh. So the middle section will be changing a bulb and a UV. I know most of you know how to do that, but not everyone does, you know. I think people forget about the beginners in the hobby. We need to make sure we give them, you know, what they need, really. So, so permission to skip that bit if you don't want to see me changing a bulb. I nearly ballsed it up myself, to be honest with you. So last night went to watch Northampton Mansfield for the playoff spot. I'll swear I'm a Jonah because they lost. Of course they did. But what made me laugh was me and the missus went to one of them e-scooters to get home on, and it was absolutely lashing down the rain. Couldn't get a cab because there's, like, you know, thousands of people coming out of the stadium. And we're only about 2 miles, a mile and a half from the stadium. And anyway, the inevitable happened, and we, because obviously we had a few beers as well. I decked pretty hard off the e-scooter. I got it all down my side, all down my leg. That's it. So it's just, any advice on the Easy Pod? How many times do you clean it? You've got to remember, my last pond, I had 2 showers, and I cleaned the sponges once a week. And that was without losing 80 litres of water every time, because the Easy Pod, you've got to dump the water, obviously. So, every day is a school day. On that note, I'm going to leave you with a Koi Beginnings outro. See you soon.
Lots of fun, I may be, but what a walk up to the pub. Literally, a walk through the forest up to the local pub. But going to see Northampton play Mansfield, they're the local team. So, walking through 2 reservoirs. Standing place. Oi, oi! Say hello! Beautiful. Right, up the cobblers, come on. So there's the reservoir, there's the stadium, see the floodlights? See how close it is. And home is about 2 minutes that way. Come on, cobblers. Hello everyone, it's the end of the week update. A few issues with the water clarity. It's so the UV was back on Monday after the treatment. Doesn't seem to be clearing out. I know it could take up to a week, but windows need a good old clean. Yeah, I was warned about this. Got 2 windows anyway, as you do. The water clarity is just horrible. And it's going to be partly, you know, being a new pond, that green coming in, but just I can't see the bottom. So I can see the fish at the window, but same around here. It's quite murky. Adam Barber happy. What I thought was a Benagoy. yeah, so I might just be being impatient, but I bought a new bulb. So, anyway, just to make sure. Let's grab that quick. That's come today. So, yeah, for anyone who's interested, I'll show you how to easily change the bulb. And Coyfish Johnny, if you're watching, I'll show you how to not electrocute yourself in the process. So, yeah, let's get this bulb changed and then, yeah, stuff to just wait. I mean, this old style Evo 25 is for up to ponds of 20,000 litres. So, I don't think it's. Maybe I need to get a bigger one. I don't know. I don't know. Let's get this changed then.
Well, it's a bit of an awkward angle to be filming, but I'll try and stay out of the shot. So, first thing is obviously turn the power off.
Yeah.
UV off. Okay. Can you see that? Dodgy light. Right, the reason I'm wearing a glove is because you're not meant to touch the bulb with your bare hands, apparently. So that's why I've got the glove on. So all you have to do is hold the white part of the UV and start unfastening the black ends. So the female threaded ends. Okay. And then that'll reveal the, you can see that, that'll reveal the electrics in there. A little an O-ring there as well, if you can see that. See the O-ring? So, there you go, there's one off. You can see that on the camera. And the same with the other side. Okay, so disconnected both ends now. This is this end, and just pull the old bulb out. Okay, there's the old bulb. Okay, you'll notice there's a bit of water on there. This is what we've got to be careful with. I mean, it looks absolutely fine, but anyway. Right, so you get your new bulb. Just thread that in. Just touch it with my hand.
Nobbo.
Right. It's got to grab something, so I'm going to pause for something. Okay, this is bloody extreme angles, this is. I'm practically on all fours. Yeah, luckily, Bisley's not around, so it should be all right. So what you've got to make sure you do is make sure these contacts on the bulb are dry, yeah? So just get a bit of tissue. Yeah, get them white. Okay, and fix your first electrical socket on. Okay, so that's in, obviously. And then pull it this end slightly. And what you want to do, you want to hold this socket here to stop the bulb from sliding out the other end. So. Okay, can you see that? So the electrical the electrics are connected on both ends. and you want to put the front of these, these O-rings need to be flat inside this female socket. Same with the other end. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. The light's not great. Right, that's tight. I'm gonna get one inside. Right, that's that. I had to stop filming for a second there because I was, because of my the angle I was sitting at, I started to nearly cross thread this one back on. So yeah, so don't do that. So. Put that UV back on. Okay. Simple as that. I've already checked if it's turned on over here, just by, you know, you can see the glowing in there. So hopefully that sorts that out. Yeah, pretty simple to do. Yeah, alright, cheers.
Right, in other news, I've got no ammonia now, but the nitrite's still quite high. This is actually on 2 parts per million. Looks worse because it's been going longer, but it's probably been there about 20 minutes now, so only a 5 minute test. Yeah, we're on 2 parts per million. It's not terrible. That needs to come down. So we are getting there. I mean, it was right up here before, and on the Colombo kit it was right up, and also just gone back to my API kit for now. Use it up, I suppose. The Colombo kit's quite expensive, isn't it? Yeah, but that's looking better. So that's thumbs up.
Right, you saw my short this morning. Got me moaning about the easy board. I just don't understand why my water's so dirty. Like, I'm barely feeding nothing. Get the nitrites down. But just look at the crap coming out of this. I don't understand it. And yeah, you get from the leaves, you can't be out, they're not making the some kinds of it or something. Good thing is I did get some bloodworms coming up, and that's a good sign of the pond. The water's well enough to the naturals to live in there, so it's got a good thing, isn't it? Yeah, so what I've done, I'm just gonna put this into my measuring bowl. See the colour of it. So,
hello.
Didn't take them long. That's the fry. That is. Look at the size of them. Yeah. So let's dump this water now. I'm just going to leave the air going. I don't know about that.
It don't look so bad, look. Oh, it looks green in the easy pellet. It's like a green colour, you know?
Oh, it's starting to go murky now. I'll get back to you. I think you're already watching this flowing out. I'll show you the my boy to death. All right, I'll get back to you in a sec. So that's the crap coming out of there. There is still a lot of, I don't know what to call it, plant life, if you like. But if you look, oh, I've lost them there.
full of bloodworm in there as well. It's really hard to see it now. It's very tiny. Maybe it's just a case of once all this debris from the trees has died off, maybe it's going to improve it. But yeah, maybe it's nothing to do with the easy pod. Yeah, is it sufficient for a 10,000 litre pond? I don't know, but I'm questioning it. I really am. Alright, well, that's it for today. Have a good... hope you enjoyed it. Alright, speak of the devil. There's one. Giant fluke. Yeah, that'll be going back in. Nice little natural to face then. Let's see. Yeah, anyway, I'll see you, catch you guys later. Cheers.